إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من بين خلقه وخليله أرسله الله بالهدى والدين الحق فأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار عياذا بالله أما بعد معاشر المؤمنين فإن الله تبارك وتعالى قد أحل لعباده المؤمنين الصالحين الطيبات من المآكل والمشارب فذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى حينما وصف نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم وأتباعه قال الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمي الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل يأمرهم بالمعروف وينهاهم عن المنكر وماذا ويحل لهم الطيبات ويحرم عليهم الخبائث ويضع عنهم إصرهم والأغلال التي كانت عليهم فالذين آمنوا به وعزروه ونصروه واتبعوا النور الذي أنزل معه أولئك هم المفلحون معاشر المؤمنين وذكر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله طيب لا يقبل إلا طيبا وإن الله أمر المؤمنين بما أمر به المرسلين حين قال يا أيها الرسل كلوا من الطيبات واعملوا صالحا فمعاشر المؤمنين بناء على ذلك علينا أن ندرك ونعلم من ضرورة الدين الإسلام أن الله سبحانه وتعالى حرم علينا كل خبيث وأحل لنا كل طيب فمن هذه الخبائث معاشر المؤمنين التي ينبغي لنا أن نحذر الخمر والمخدرات وكل ما هو من الإدمان معاشر المؤمنين ويدخل في ذلك كل مشروب ومأكول سواء كان ذلك عبر الحبوب أو استنشاقا أو الإبر أو غير ذلك معاشر المؤمنين ويدخل في حكم ذلك معاشر المؤمنين حتى أتصفح في الإنترنت ومثلا على سبيل المثال على مجالات الوسائل الاجتماعية مثل فيسبوك وتويتر وغير ذلك فإنه للمؤمنين معاشر المؤمنين ينبغي أن ندرك بأنه يمكن أن يكون الإدمان في هذه النشاطات وعلينا أن نحذر فإن الله سبحانه وتعالى حرم علينا الخمر لأنه أم الخبائث وعليه قاس العلماء قديما وحديثا كل ما في معنى ذلك كل ما فيه إفساد للدين والعقل والمروءة وفيه تضييق للوقت وأضرار نفسية وصحية واجتماعية وفكرية. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى للمؤمنين حينما ذكر في كتابه: يا أيها المؤمنون، إن الله حرم عليكم الخمر والميسر والأنساب والأجزام فإنه رجس من عمل الشيطان فاجتنبوه لعلكم تفلحون. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ذكر بأن كل مسكر فإنه خمر، سواء أسكر ذلك قليله وكثيره. معاشر المؤمنين، للمؤمنين أن يدركوا، بارك الله فيكم، أن في مجتمعاتنا الإسلامية، سواء كنا في الغربة في الأقليات الإسلامية، أو سواء كنا في بلادنا في العالم الإسلامي، أن هذه الأمراض والمشاكل أنها تدمر وتفكك الوحدة الاجتماعية والأسرية. ونحن نعايش هذا الواقع المرير حتى في مدينتنا هذه، فكم من بيوت تعاني من هذه المشاكل. فعلى مسؤولي البيوت والأهالي وأصحاب المؤسسات أن يدركوا هذه الخطورة، وأن يعلموا أسباب انتشار هذه الأمراض، فإن لها أسباب انتشار عدة، ولعلنا نحصي من أهمها. فأولها ورئيسها وأهمها ضعف الوازع الديني، أي ضعف الإيمان، فإن ضعف الإيمان هو سبب لهذه الأمراض. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: ألا إن في الجسد مضغة، إذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله، وإذا فسدت فسد الجسد كله، ألا وهي القلب. وإنما يستقيم أمر القلب بالإيمان والدين واليقين والتوحيد. معاشر المؤمنين، ومن أسباب انتشار هذه الأمراض، أي أسباب انتشار المخدرات والإدمان وهذه التعاطيات، أصحاب السوء وأصدقاء السوء. وأيضا من أهم أسباب انتشارها مما نرى ونعايش وسائل الإعلام التي تزين للمسلمين وحتى لغير المسلمين تعاطي هذه الخمور والمخدرات، وتخيل لهم أن هذه من الذكورة وأنها تزيد في النشاط والفكر. معاشر المؤمنين، علينا أن ندرك بأن هذه الخطورات التي نوجهها لا بد لها من جهود متكاتفة، فإنه لا يستطيع الفرد بوحده أن يحله، لكن المسؤولية تبدأ من الفرد. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. فالرجل هو راع ومسؤول عن أهل بيته، فعليه أن يتفقد أحوال أولاده، وعليه أن ينشئهم النشأة والتنشئة والتربية الإسلامية، حتى يغرس فيهم الوازع الديني والإيماني، حتى يكون ذلك وقاية لهم حينما يكبروا من أن لا يقعوا في مثل هذه المعاصي. معاشر المؤمنين، إن لهذه الخمور والمخدرات وهذه الأسباب وأسباب انتشارها فإنها خطيرة جدا، فهي تسبب الفشل في الدين والعقوبات التي لا نستطيع أن ندرك حقيقتها في الآخرة. ولكن معاشر المؤمنين، علينا أن لا نفقد الأمل والرجاء في الله سبحانه وتعالى. فأقول لك أيها الأخ المؤمن، أو أيتها الأخت المؤمنة، إذا كنت ممن أصيب بمثل هذه الأمراض، فعليك أن تدرك أن الله سبحانه وتعالى أنه هو تواب رحيم يقبل توبة العبد. معاشر المؤمنين، توبوا إلى الله جميعا أيها المؤمنون لعلكم تفلحون. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم، ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. قد قلت ما سمعتم، وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين، فاستغفروه وتوبوا إليه، إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله على إحسانه، وشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا الداعي إلى رضوان. أما بعد، dear brothers and sisters in Islam, after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bearing witness that none deserves to be worshipped in truth except him alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And bearing witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and messenger. Indeed, it is upon us to know and realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made halal for us every single good thing, and that he made haram, that he made it prohibited for us every single thing that is harmful and that causes danger to us, whether it be in our health, our bodies, our intellect, our wealth, and even our honor and prestige. For that reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he described the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his followers, he said, it is those people who believe and follow in the unlettered Prophet. For indeed, this unlettered Prophet, Allah went on subhanahu wa ta'ala to describe him with attributes and characteristics. And amongst the most important of them was that it is he who made lawful for the believers that which is good and that which is pure for them, and that it is he who made unlawful for them every single thing that causes harm and that is a danger to them. And that indeed, by this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed from them the hardship which was upon the previous nations. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, indeed, in an authentic hadith narrated by Imam Muslim in his Sahih, that indeed Allah is good and pure, and he only accepts that which is good and pure. And that indeed he commanded the messengers and the prophets that which he commanded the believers to do, when he said, oh you prophets, we have indeed commanded you to eat from the good and for you to do righteous actions. Once we know this, dear brothers and dear sisters in Islam, it is upon us to realize that therefore every single thing which goes against this rule of purity and goodness and being wholesome and something that causes us to be nurtured upon righteousness and virtue and piety, that anything that opposes it is therefore illegal and unlawful and harmful in Islam. So upon this, when we look at our reality, and when we look at this reality with an eye of intensity, indeed it is a very sad and it's a very sobering reality that we see the spread of things which are addictive to the Muslim community and in our very community here in this very city of ours. We see our dear brothers and sisters who are being trialed by certain addictions, whether it be addictions to alcohol or to certain substances like drugs and other harmful substances which people can get easily addicted to, or furthermore, even more subtle than that. For indeed, how do you realize, their brother and their sister in Islam, that addiction is not just what we perhaps understand in that it is just about alcohol and drugs. For indeed, do you know, their brother and their sister in Islam, that addiction even goes beyond that, to extend to, let's say, for example, addiction to internet surfing, to addiction to video games and online computer games, and addiction to things such as being hooked on social media. For indeed, this is one of the harms that we are seeing, it's very bitter reality in this community. For indeed, we see complaints about the harmful nature of these things and how they are dividing communities and how they are splitting and causing so much conflict in families to the extent that it causes divorce and children are being raised in single parent families, and that they are forced to go through life without being equipped with the tools that will enable them to have a good and a stable foundation so that they can grow up without being trapped in these traps of addiction, whether it be to substances or to things more subtle than that, like games and gambling and being hooked on social media. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, indeed it is important for us, if we are going to address this as a community, for us first of all to address the most important ways in which these afflictions and these issues are spread in the community. For indeed, the first and the most important of these things, the reasons why addiction is becoming a more important issue and a more dangerous and pressing issue in our community is, of course, and according to our religious faith, is because of that weakness in faith and iman. For indeed, iman acts as a kind of shield for the believer. For indeed, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in reinforcing the importance of having a heart that is nurtured upon the correct faith and the correct creed, he said, indeed, in the body is a morsel of flesh. If it's pure, then the whole body becomes pure. It becomes righteous. And if it becomes corrupted by anything, if it becomes weakened, the immune system indeed becomes weakened, and therefore you see that manifest upon the body. So therefore, when we see these things, they are indeed attesting to that which is in the inside. And of course, with Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we believe that Iman, indeed it comprises of both things that are in the heart, but also they are manifest upon the body. So we do not separate the actions of the body from the actions of the heart. We are not the people that say, but brother, don't judge me, as long as my heart is pure, then it doesn't matter what I do. No, that is a wrong ideology. For indeed, the actions of our body, they reflect the realities of our hearts. Indeed, this is the first and the most crucial reason behind the spread of such afflictions and such social issues. Next in the line is indeed the inappropriate or improper tarbiyah, i.e. that we are not being cultivated, or children and Muslim homes are not given the right upbringing upon Islam. For indeed, when children are raised in their households and they are not educated about the dangers of certain substances, and furthermore, they are not given the proper identity, not only with regards to their religion, this is halal, this is haram, but so that they are assured about who they are and about the dangers of these substances. For indeed, how many people, the research has shown that when Muslim parents just say to their children, this is haram, that's haram, that these people are junkies. For indeed, one day the child may grow up and say, okay, these people are junkies, but I see that maybe they have an interesting life, so let me try it. So it's very important for the parents to equip their children with the proper tools so that they are able to face these realities when they grow up. And indeed, from the most important of reasons as well for this is, of course, the media. For indeed, that which we are shown, whether it be through television or through internet media, in that society seems to glorify this kind of life of drug addiction, or this life of drinking alcohol, that it has become a part and parcel of the culture of this country. And of course, we have respect for everybody. But however, when it comes to our religion, we say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He is the one who created us, and therefore knows that which is best for us and righteous for us, of course He is going to legislate for us that which is good, and make unlawful for us that which is harmful. So He made things like alcohol harmful for us, and likewise all the other things over which alcohol has been given an analogy. So therefore the scholars, whether it be recent or back in the day, they have always used the analogy of alcohol. For indeed, the prohibition of alcohol is clear in the book of Allah, when Allah said that indeed alcohol and gambling and the slaughtering on the altars are all rijis. It is all an impurity and is from the work of the shaitan. So therefore stay away from it. For indeed, the shaitan only wants to sow in between you the seeds of division and discord and disagreement. So therefore stay away from his plans and his plots. So therefore it is very important for us to make a realization of this, and not to be shy of our religious identity in saying that this is unlawful for us, and teaching our children that, and bringing our families up upon that. And of course, it is very important for us, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, indeed all of you are shepherds over your flock. All of you have a responsibility, whether it be that you are a man who is responsible over your household, you are a husband who is responsible over the unity of their family, or you are a mother and a wife responsible over their household as well, that indeed Allah is going to test you about your responsibility. So therefore it is very sad as a reality that we see this, the spread of this. And these kind of problems, they cannot be solved by just one person. It requires the whole of the community to work together. But as I said, it begins with the individual. So you have to start with your own self. That you, oh you servant of Allah, you check yourself. Are you somebody who has this element, this affliction? The first step to addressing is acknowledging that. For indeed, some of us may live in denial and saying, I don't have a problem. And they may lie about it to cover it up. But indeed, the first step of Tawbah is always an i'tiraf, for you to acknowledge it. For you to say, yes, I have this problem. Because the moment you start doing that, then you're on your first step towards getting help. And indeed, it is important for the different Islamic institutions and communities for them to set up programs to help people who have these kind of issues, whether it be community gatherings, whether it be that they have coffee mornings, or whether they have specific departments within their institutions, within their mosques, that help people with these kind of addictive problems, offering them the solutions, offering them counseling. And indeed, of course, that this is something that we as a community have to embrace, that it is not only that we have to serve each other, But also we have to ask, what can we offer the wider Scottish community? For indeed our religion has given us so many tools for us to share. The tools of Iman, the tools of having the faith in Allah, the faith in the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the tools of knowing that everything that we do in this life, that Allah is looking at us. So therefore it compels us to fear Allah. And indeed, because these addictive things are so harmful in this life and in the next, we know that it is best for our welfare in this life and the next that we stay away from them. Indeed, dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has asked us to send praise and salutation upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Fa Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad, kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innaka hamidun majid. Ubarik Allah Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad, kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, innaka hamidun majid. Warda Allahumma anis sahabati ajma'in, Abi Bakrin wa Umar wa Uthman wa Ali, wa anna ma'ahum منك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم آمنا في أوطاننا وأصلح أئمتنا وولاة أمورنا. اللهم اهدنا واهد شبابنا. اللهم فذنا من كل سوء ومكروه برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم من أرادنا وأراد الإسلام بسوء فأشغله بنفسي واجعل دائرة عليه وأرنا فيهم أجائب قدرتك يا قوي يا عزيز. اللهم كن لإخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان، اللهم كن لهم معينا وناصرا يا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آمنا في أوطاننا، اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أقيموا الصلاة.